count up.
Well, we're live now.
That's funny. Okay.
So the first thing they hear is you criticizing my producing skills.
Yep.
You said count to three. I did count to three. Hi, everyone.
So, as normal, we'll give everybody a chance to get on. I've been painting pretty much all day. So there's a lot more done on the painting than we had last night. And my plan was to paint every single piece of this on here, on Twitch, but I kind of got overzealous and couldn't just stare at it all day. So I jumped aboard and started painting. Now I'm painting a lot of blotchy veins and trying to get the nastiest skin texture I can. Like you can see the skin texture I painted on the kid there. And I'm just going for disgustingly gross without just gore.
Jeremy and Shakar say hello.
Hey there. So, it may look like I'm doing, I know that this appears kind of like magic to you artists out there that are wondering how the hell you do this. I'll tell you a secret. I'll tell you the truth. I've never painted a big, giant, blue, veiny arm before. So, I just kind of see what happens. Let it go. Like these purple veins I put down, when I first put them down, they look terrible. They're really way too bright. But now I come back in and I wash over them, and they look great. They kind of change colors and look like they're underneath the skin now. And I'm doing this by trial and error. I've never been taught this. But I've got a pretty sound theory on it. My theory's holding true. I felt that it would do, it would have this appearance, and it has. My shadows are all these deep reds and purples.
Shia says, so I can't hang out every night. I have class from 2:30 to 9 p.m. on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And Jesse says, yo, all.
Yeah, I was thinking about that. I know that a lot of people come on to watch me that stay up real late in different parts of the world. I've been wondering if I should,
start earlier?
No, take a day off so that people could sleep. We start earlier. Remember, we couldn't start earlier because nobody was there. It's too early. It's the time people are driving home, getting out of work and such.
Yeah. Jeremy says, no rest for the weekend.
Ain't that the truth? No. Well, I know this. I've never achieved anything of any significance by being lazy or procrastinating. Or just deciding that I'm going to put in just enough. I'll tell you this. Anytime you go and you do your job, you paint. You paint it as if you were paid $1 million to do it. You put everything in every time you do a project. Don't shortcut it. You know, I've heard this from a lot of artists. And they'll, you know, they get paid. They didn't get paid as much as they wanted, which is always blown out of proportion because they think they deserve a lot more than they do. But, you know, I remember when I began, one of the guys that I was working with, I was working for, told me, never give anybody a dime more work than they paid for. You know, if they paid $50 for a drawing, you don't do an ounce of work more than that. And that right there is the dumbest, worst friggin' advice you could get. You know? And he is nowhere to be found. Has no art career. Yeah, but he didn't work a dime more than he was paid.
Good for him. He stuck to his scruples.
My argument always was, well, how does anybody know what I was paid? You know, it's not like I could put the artwork out and say, yeah, well, I was only paid this much for it, so I'm not going to work that hard.
It's so stupid.
Oh, yeah, well, there's plenty of that in the world. I may not be a genius, but I'm not dumb.
So why don't you tell them what you did with the darks? Because they can see it, and it looks much different.
Oh, yes. Well, this right here, I decided to... Normally, I never use a black. But the paper that I used, I forgot a step.
Dun, dun, dun.
And I did not wash the sizing off the paper. Normally, before I started painting, this paper that I'm painting on would have been soaked for like an hour in a tub. And it lifts all the sizing out of the paper. The sizing is what happens when you see all these blacks that are now gray and hazy. That's from the sizing. So I can't change that now. Nothing I could do about that now. So I decided to change and use some actual Holbein blacks. And it's mixed in with a blue. And then a purple base.
So it's not straight black.
No, it's not straight black. And it'll create more depth. And when I hit the whole thing with, when I varnish the painting, all my grays right now will turn to black. So I will get the look that I want. This just makes it easier to paint it so that I can actually see what is in true black. Remember, black is the absence of light, but it also is all color.
So that's why your black doesn't look flat.
Yeah.
Because you've got the blue and the purple in there.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And you switched brushes again.
Oh, I've been switching brushes like crazy. But on the hands and the larger shapes, I'm actually using oil brushes, which will give me a nice stiff bristle and really puts the paint down well. I think that's the biggest difference you're going to find with brushes. It's just the way they lay the paint down. You can have the exact same paint, exact same paper, and you try a different brush and it reacts completely differently.
people say you're doing an excellent job of keeping your head out of the shot.
I'm actually trying to.
I was commending you on your efforts.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So, I painted this guy, and can you see the hands?
Yes. It's right at the edge of the screen, but yes.
And I went back over and I was doing his shirt, which is funny because trying to paint something to look dirty is actually pretty hard. But I like the way it came out. And of course I want these children to look completely disturbing, but not necessarily a zombie, but I keep thinking about these kids trapped in the nightmare. Imagine a nightmare you just can't wake up from. So until our lead dreamer there decides to let them go, they are prisoners, essentially. I'm really just going directly over my initial drawing. Everything that you see painted was drawn in detail. Like I always tell my students, whoever draws the best paints the best. Now, if you see here, I'm putting my pinky down.
Pinky up.
What?
Pinky up, when you drink.
Yeah, I'm putting my pinky down on the paper so that I have something to lean on and I'm not putting my whole hand down on to the painting. It's a little tricky to do. It takes some time to get used to. But it's a good way to be able to do this kind of stuff. Keep a little bit more control over the brush. Now, it's funny, I watched having to do these stones. I actually watched a painter that I think is fantastic on YouTube. I was looking to see how his philosophy on painting stones. Unfortunately, he's a mural painter. So everything he did with a giant brush and really big.
Is that the guy that painted the sky in the church?
Yeah,
oh, okay.
Joe the Muralist. He's really good. Like, funny thing is, he'd probably be put down just for because all he does is murals. But the man can paint. Oof. And I love that. Yeah. There's so few left. They say this is a dying art. When I hear things that the powers that be say that this kind of work won't even exist, in the future, that really breaks my heart. So my goal is to inspire you guys out there to pick up a paintbrush and prove those bastards wrong. How this could ever die is beyond me. How people could ever want to lose that connection, that feeling of creation. But I guess it all goes back to the ease. You know, they want it easy.
Quiet in our room tonight.
It happens.
We're listening to Tommy. Down in front, Jeremy says.
Yeah, I remember when we were first talking about this, and people were saying, oh, it's so hard, because you have to keep talking.
Well, that is definitely not something you find difficult anymore.
No, I was like, I could talk. Well, when I taught at the college, you had to talk for 90 minutes every class. You have to give a 90-minute lecture.
Really?
Yep.
Hmm.
That's most colleges.
Yeah. I had 4-hour classes, so it was more than 90 minutes.
Well, no, but the professor is, you know, supposed to talk for 90 minutes, and the rest is supposed to be, you know, interaction. And before I really built up a syllabus, you know, I used to wing it and have no idea what the hell I was going to talk about. So I would just talk about whatever job I had that week. Or whatever project I was working on and how I went about doing it.
Did people like that?
Yeah, they actually do. Well, it was very helpful. The funny part is I got more, every week I'd get more and more other professors sitting in the class because they wanted to be freelance illustrators. But they were teachers.
So Jeremy says, still do living proof. There are 2-hour, 30-minute, once-a-week classes. I hate teaching them.
Hmm. The way I had it set up at the last college I taught, it was in the... I lived in Pennsylvania, and it was in New Jersey. So they scheduled all my classes for one day a week. So I taught from... let's see, about a 9 o'clock class. And my last class of the day ended at 11:30 at night. So I was just there all day. I missed that school. I remember the first day I got there, and I brought a bunch of pages and paintings, you know, to show the kids who I was and what I did. And I ran into one of the professors, and my portfolio, one of the portfolios, was out on the table. And the professor was scoffing at it. Yeah, because he's a scholar. And whoever did those was, it's just comic books, you know, fantasy art, just crap.
Right.
And he's trying to, like, tell the kids that they're stupid for liking it. You know, I said to him, you know, I'm new here, but can I ask you a question? He was like, yes. And I was like, so, fundamentally, you know, do you not like it because the perspective? And what perspective is it? And it was Batman leaping backwards into the city with a four-point
elliptical
perspective. And then we talked about composition and every element that I could think of. And, of course, it hit everything. And I said, so you're just an asshole. And he's like, I take it you're Tommy. I was like, when it suits me.
Okay, Batman.
How'd you know I was Batman?
I stalked you before I ever met you.
That's true.
Jeremy says, for us non-art types, what is a four-point elliptical perspective?
It's, the perspective is round.
I would say that is Greek to me, but I know Greek. Funny. I'll pull up an example.
To best describe it, it's like looking through a fish lens.
Fish eye?
Yeah, fish eye. I do it to show off. It's the most advanced perspective that I know how to do.
There you go. I just put up an example. Jeremy said, I had a great chat online today with Primo about composition, about how to have things point to the main focus of the painting and how to draw a person into the painting and keep them there. We also talked a little about storytelling and how to leave some of the story open to the viewer. Any thoughts on either subject?
Did he tell you I taught him all of that? And I have many thoughts on those subjects. I could go on for hours. You know, storytelling is what we do every day with this. You know, convey from concept to completion. You know, telling the tales of and woes of our characters. You know, making people believe that it's possible. You know, so you'll care about them.
Jesse said, LOL, he didn't need to.
That's all right. There's just another artist that I've taught that does not give me credit. But all artists act like they discovered the wheel.
Mm-hmm. I didn't.
No, you didn't.
Then again, I'm not technically an artist. Not a working one, anyway.
Could you give me another napkin, please? This one's toast.
Okay. That one's toast. That's a magic trick. Tommy turned paper into toast. Is that like, when a door's not a door? Here you go, my love.
When it's a jar?
Yep, when it's a jar.
Is that supposed to be smart people jokes?
No, it's supposed to be silly. Jeremy says, that is because you did discover the wheel.
Yeah.
And Shakar says, I don't.
I like telling people that I invented the question mark.
Then I comment that the ampersand would have been more impressive.
I need new water.
Mom needs new water.
Water's like brown.
Mom's like brown.
My mom is like brown. Mm-hmm. You're right. If brown was insane and mean.
If by brown you meant, I meant insane and mean.
Mm-hmm.
Dun, 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 dun.
Now this paint also dries instantly when it hits the board. So there is little to no blending once you put it down. If you see me wiping it, I'm wiping it on this napkin I have here. Just so that I can control the amount of paint that goes down on the board.
Whew, that was nasty.
What was?
You had a lot of pigment built up in there, so it smelled.
Oh, yeah.
It smelled like nasty, old, musty gym socks.
Mm-hmm. That happens. So what do you guys think? Do you like the pieces that I did today? Anybody have any comments, any questions?
I made a comment about getting a book on composition, and he told me to get books by Frazetta, Pyle, and Wyeth and study them. I was like, yep. That's a Tommy response. And he never came across like these were his ideas. He was just passing on what he knew.
Good. Remember, composition is balance. Forget all the terms. Forget all the bull crap that they try and put down your throat. It's balance. If the balance is off, the art is off. If it looks right and feels right, it's right. I always try and teach composition, you know, by explaining it like it's a, you know, it's a stick or a shape trying to balance on its own. And if it's off, it's going to teeter to one way or the other.
Rev Chumley says, hey, Sammy, Tommy, he put me first. Say hello.
Hello.
Ladies first, always first. Greetings. Hi, Devilique. Welcome back.
Mm-hmm. Almost put that right in my drink.
I saw that. Oh, good fun. Oh, man down. That's why you have an OtterBox.
Yeah.
The moderators are out in force tonight.
What's that?
Oh, Devilique and Rev are mods in our channel. So half the people that are in here are moderators. I pity anybody coming in and talking crap at our channel.
Wow, they print this small.
What are you looking for?
Making sure this is the right one.
The cream?
Yeah.
Let me see.
I think
beige.
That should be it.
Beige it is.
Yeah, that's it.
Hindu Art says, building a mod wall. Let's see. Devilique, hi, how y'all been? The painting looks amazeballs.
Thank you.
He can actually see. That's why it looks so amazeballs. Jeremy says, LOL, so many times have I cleaned my brush in my tea. I know the pain, Tommy.
Mm-hmm. I actually, when I was younger, got poisoned.
Heavy metal poisoning.
From painting and oils in my very first studio, which was actually my brother Joey's. He had built a little studio in the backyard for his band. And you would know my brother Joey, he actually played drums for a very short time, but he played drums for Skid Row. So he had long been living in Florida at that point, and I took over his little studio area as my first painting studio. And it had no ventilation, and I had no idea what I was doing. And I used to have a habit of switching brushes and putting one in my mouth. You can see I load the table up now with brushes.
As opposed to sticking them in your mouth?
Mm-hmm.
Devilique says, super happy that Tommy is feeling better.
Yeah, it makes things a lot easier. There we go. We can just wash his blue right onto him. And you should be able to see all of the colors. I don't know if the computer is picking it up.
Yeah, it's doing it.
You should see all the purples and reds and greens in his skin. And again, this is in order to create depth. A lot of the coloring that's been done, a lot of the artwork that's been done for this game has been very... You know, they did a nice job, but they did what's typical today. You know, every single thing is modeled in most likely Illustrator or Photoshop, so they have no texture. And they could have faked it too. They could have gone and created a layer or scanned in a piece of paper and created a layer and let that texture of the paper come through. You know, I've seen people try and fake it that way. But I've never seen a program or used anything that can beat paint. You know, nothing out there makes the looks more like watercolor than watercolor. I always got a kick out of it that all they do is create these programs to mimic what we already have. That's funny to me. But luckily, I don't understand artists.
Do you consider yourself one?
Me?
Yes.
No, I'm a businessman that makes art. Unfortunately, I find it embarrassing to put myself in the same category as them. And I'm not saying that I'm better and perfect and, you know, all I'm saying is that I disagree wholeheartedly with their methodologies. You know, so I cannot and will not be part of that. But yeah, I could have just jumped on the computer and been another drone.
Probably would have been finished by now.
Oh, by far. And there would never be the painting.
Of course.
You know, it would not exist. It would not come to life. You know, so once again, we'd be artistically starved. Again, I just don't get it. If all you care about is making money as quick as possible, don't be an artist.
Right.
You know? All right. The other part funny is most artists I know come from rich families. Very few of us came from poverty. So I don't know why they're so starved to make money. Trust fund babies, what have you. I don't know, do you consider me an artist?
It depends on what your definition of artist is. Let's see, Devil League says, yes, stop starving the children. Mix the paint and soar. Into Art says, the technology is rigged so that art, be it 2D or 3D, is produced much faster. Much is lost in the translation, but jobs are done quickly and can be changed in the blink of an eye.
Yeah, and that's really sad. You know, I get the need for speed. You know, but at the cost of integrity, the loss of a literally a dying art. Yeah, I mean, but even with all of that, what is the big rush? Why are we in such a rush? Where the hell's everybody going? You know, why do I have to have a phone on me 24/7 so that I can, you know, hear about something immediately? That doesn't matter. Matter of fact, if anybody knows anyone, my mod book is going up for sale this week. I've got a 13-inch mod book. If you don't know what that is, it's a full Cintiq built right on top of a MacBook Pro.
So it's basically a traveling Cintiq.
Yep. For a while there, I had an endorsement from the company.
Into art says, beautifully said, Tommy.
What was beautifully said?
What you were talking about previously.
Oh, yes. Thank you. How's that arm look?
Looks awesome. I like it.
Let's try and leave these pot marks.
Yeah, that looks great. Good texture in that.
Like I said from the beginning, anything worth doing is worth doing well. That doesn't mean it's worth doing at 100 miles per hour to get it done, get it done, get it done. It's just sad for our future. You know, no more paintings in museums. You'll go to a museum to see a bunch of prints out and computer screens. And I'm sure they'll close just like libraries. What do you need the printed word for? Sounds like a bad horror sci-fi movie to me.
Oh, you mean that thing we just watched?
No, that wasn't even... I don't even know what the hell that was.
I would so love to join one of Tommy's ateliers, Indu Art says.
Yeah, unfortunately, the school was going quite well, but it also meant giving up, you know, my career. So we had to close the doors. That's why we're in here.
Mm-hmm.
And this one you don't have to pay for. Of course, I don't make money off this one. But it's more important things than money.
I like the burnt sienna shadow in there.
Yeah, it's kind of cool, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, maybe next year I'll go back to a college and start teaching again. I do miss it.
Tevalik says, how are the baby dogs?
Uzi's not feeling too well. She's been pretty much sleeping all day. We're taking her to a vet tomorrow. But the dogs have better health care than I do.
She says, we just got a new little gal, wired haired.
Oh yeah, send a picture.
Yeah. Yeah, we're looking at getting a puppy in the next couple months. Right?
Yep. I kind of favor a dapple.
Yeah, we gotta find a dapple. Gotta find a breeder. Blake says, oh no, I hope she feels better soon. Yeah, a couple weeks ago, Uzi had to have, get spayed and have a, have surgery because she had two mammary tumors. So, she got those removed and she got spayed. So, that's a couple weeks ago, so we think she's just getting sore. I hope she's just getting sore and there's nothing serious going on elsewise. Devil League says, I have a dapple.
That's great. I also have a tendency to hold my right arm with my left hand while I'm painting. See, I'm actually holding my arm. That way I can lean on my left arm to control the movement of the right.
Create stability.
Yep. You know, and also remember not to hound down on your brush. Don't be right on the edge. Grab it a little further back.
Justin says, got a haircut today. Now I have a mini Tommy Hawk.
Awesome.
Starting a trend, honey.
Yeah, I knew you would. Knew I would.
Knew I would? Yeah.
I said I knew I would.
Uh-huh.
All I have to do is get guys to stop wearing flannel
and skinny jeans.
Skinny jeans. You know, the fake men.
Yep. You gotta tell them about the dream that you had about when you died. The game show host, the game show one?
Oh, yeah. So I was telling Sammy, I had a dream the other night that I died. And she had a game show where my body was laid out. And artists were given sections of my body to complete artworks. So they had to use a severed arm, you know, different pieces. I forget what happened, though.
The lumbersexual was bragging that he was the best or something.
Yeah, and you threw him out of the show.
Yeah. I like that I had a game show using your corpse.
Yeah, that's fine.
You to make them stop, you need to wear skinny jeans. Justin says.
I'd rather wear dress.
You know, there's actually a scientific study about the boys wearing skinny jeans as they're growing up and hitting puberty, that it actually constricts the growth of their man parts, so they will have a smaller quirkiness and have, you know, since there's no room for them to expand. Yeah. Got it. Let's see what the puppy looks like. Aww.
I want to see.
Here, look. Turn your head.
Hold on.
What's her name? How old is she?
Can you give me two more napkins, editor?
Haha, I logged in and the first thing I heard was saying, Tommy, I'd rather wear a dress, Poodle Mama says. Two more napkins, sir.
Thank you.
Ugh. Justin says it also causes gangrene if they're not careful. She's a pound puppy, a year old, and her name is Annie. Aw, so she's Orphan Annie! So does that mean that Rev is Daddy Robux? Warbux? Does he know FDR too and have a helicopter? Devilique says, yeah, so cute. Her hair is wild. She's my little wild woman. And here's their mini dap. Oh, look, he's got a... Look at him, he's got a... Looks like he's got a beard.
Mm.
It's awesome.
That's awesome.
We need to make it like a prerequisite that you have to have a dachshund to be on this stream. Have a dachshund meetup. His name is Tuck Tuck Chicken Butt.
But they call him Willie for short.
But they call him Willie for short. No, that is his short name. My name is Bob. But they call me Tuck Tuck Chicken Butt for short. That sounds like it needs to be a song. Like a jingle. Where did that name come from?
Is Nathan on tonight?
No. Tori. The man's allowed to have a life, you know.
Whatever.
Whatever. I think at some point he would just want to be surprised. You know?
Mm-hmm.
Like, I would, like, if I was him, I would watch a good chunk of it and then just not watch it anymore because I'd want to be surprised at what the finished product looked like.
Yeah, everybody's different. I painted a motorcycle. It's 100,000 dollar motorcycle. And the people flew here from England and sat in my garage to watch me paint it.
That's right. And I remember they wanted to make coffee and they didn't know how to use an American coffee maker.
Mm-hmm.
So they filled the reservoir with water and then put the coffee grinds in the water. And they left the filter empty.
Yeah, they used to laugh when I asked them if they wanted a cup of tea.
Yeah. His past owner... Okay, so Devil Leak said, I used to call my kid Chicken Butt as a joke when she was little. She named him that when we adopted him. His past owner called him Tucker the Ucker. Oh, Tucker the F-er.
Oh, yeah.
As there is a an asterisk.
So it was Tucker the Plucker.
Or the Sucker. Or the Mucker. Ducker. Bucker.
Now, here's a little trick. If you want to cover an area with paint and you know, you're afraid that as soon as you put the line down, you're going to have that sharp edge of paint, wet it first. Now just wet the area. And then when you come down, drop your paint on it. It won't just stop and create a ledge. What's right in there, babe?
I was just talking about the dogs. You were talking about techniques. I didn't think you'd want me to interrupt you about dogs.
Now, like we said before, this guy is primarily a purple-blue, but the artist that did the first drawings made everything purple blue. So we don't want that. So we're trying to create a little bit more diversity in our color palette. But still trying to stay true to the company look. And you're going to want to move fast. Acrylics sometimes can be very unforgiving. What I'm doing right now is painting the the area outside my main figure. So I'm painting the air. And from this point, I'm actually going to have to flip the whole painting upside down. Yeah, so let's do that. Ugh. Remember now, maybe he has, maybe your monster has a happy little tongue right here. Mm-hmm. And let's say that tongue has just warts in it. Yeah. Remember, think happy herpes. Maybe it turns really green at the top.
Question is, how did Bob Ross keep his afro out of the way of his camera?
They had somebody walking with the camera.
That's not fair.
And he was in an entire
no, that's not fair.
Film studio.
No. Unacceptable.
Yeah, he had a little bit more of an advantage.
No.
Yeah.
You are doing excellently at keeping your head out of the way. I'm very proud of you. I didn't mean that to sound condescending.
No.
No.
You're like, you're a retard. I didn't mean that to be insulting.
I didn't see that.
Okay, so we paint in stages. So I just laid all that down. And now, you know, I want to put in the highlights, but I'm not going to use just pure white. So we'll start right around the ridge of his head here. You know, I've got a beige mixed with a little bit of cadmium yellow. And we'll start bringing all that wrinkly, you know, demon skin up. Thank you. And we're just going over the areas that are being touched by light. And letting the other pieces fade into the back. Again, our job is to manipulate light. You can see it starts to come together. What do you think? See that?
Nice. See, Double Eek says, cool, I was looking at one down below Nashville. They have a short-haired blue. I will go look it up. Give me a minute. Okay, is it just me, or do you spend more time detailing smaller items than you do large items? I'm thinking of some of smaller figures on the bottom as opposed to the huge arm. Is it just that the smaller items need more attention?
It's not that the smaller items need more attention. I spend a lot of time detailing it because I'm a stickler for detail. You know, it's what I enjoy. Painting big open areas is fine, but it's a bit boring. I like the little details. To me, it brings it to life. But this guy right here is pretty big, and he'll have just as much detail, if not more, than those cats down at the bottom. But again, it's about balance. If I feel that he needs it, he will get more or less detail accordingly. But all around the eye, eyes are the windows to the soul. If you get the eye right, you're golden. If you get that eye wrong, everything falls apart. The center does not hold. And the darks that you see me putting in are actually green. It's a very deep green. And I want that deep green because I know that right here, these little sections over here are red eyeballs. So I fill the background in here, all the shadows with my nice dark green. When I put that red in, it's going to make it pop. What's awesome?
The blue that they're looking at. The little blue dachshund. He's so cute.
Let me see.
Can you see that? Is that better?
He looks like a Doberman.
He's gray and tan. He's blue and tan. And is adorable.
He is. Then again, I'm...
Puppyfind.com. I've never heard of that. Have you found puppies on there before? Speaking of puppies. Let's see here. Party Jake! Usually Tommy is churning out pieces every hour and they are great, but it is such a pleasure to see him work on a big piece like this, and we get to see it develop day to day. Let's see. Poodle Mama says, oh, I can't stand it. Meaning the puppy. Shai says, Shakar, I know you primarily work with paint, but how would I do an underpainting like you did, but in markers and overlay the color to give it a more vivid, rich look?
Well, you'd need a marker that is a transparent. So you don't want to use... You probably want to use Copics.
Yeah.
You know, if you try and use like a Tombone or, you know, any of the, what's the other, what's the P one? The name of it's eluding me.
What?
markers stuff.
Black?
No, the, you know, they make pencils.
Prismacolor.
Prismacolor, yes. Those are completely opaque and have no real blending qualities whatsoever. I remember 25 years ago, there was a job painting, airbrushing guitars that I went for, and I didn't get it, but the artist that got it was, you know, a seasoned guy, and he pulled me to the side and said, "Do you want to know why you didn't get the job?" Of course, I said, "Yes." He said, "I didn't get it because I didn't understand highlights." And the only difference was his had highlights, mine did not. So after that, I never got highlights wrong again. But they will make all the difference in the world. If you build with shadow, you know, and you have light and structured, then you can come back in with highlights and emphasize detail. You know, draw attention. Pull attention away.
Hmm.
What?
Ton of male dachshunds up for sale on this puppy website.
Oh, yeah?
And a ton in our area. $500, 6 weeks, dachshund. $500.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, his name's Binks.
Why do they name them?
He's 6 weeks old. I don't know. One in Largo.
Key Largo?
No, just Largo. Key Largo is one of the keys.
I know, that's all I was asking.
No, just Largo. It's south. There's one named Butch, he's 9 days old. A lot of males.
Yeah.
I guess people don't want males. Oh, we can get a mini Oliver. A red smooth. He looks just like Oliver as a puppy. Oh my God, we can have a mini Oliver. Look! I'm totally the crazy dog lady that would go and show this to Uzi and Oliver and go, "Which one do you think?" Evelie goes, oh no, what have I done? Because I was looking up the website.
So you wind up pushing back and pulling forward when you're painting. Yeah. And I usually do this both at the same time.
Ooh, that's a little too sharp.
What was?
It's a little blurry, so I was just sharpening it up a little bit. And I went to like 200, and I was like, wow, that's a little too sharp.
It feels good not to be banging out a painting every 20 minutes.
Does it?
Mm-hmm.
Good. I'm glad.
I've been dying to be able to get back to this.
I think she's glad.
Now, trick to painting teeth is always add plaque. I never leave the teeth pure white.
Poor dental hygiene.
It's more believable.
Yeah. I can't imagine Lord Chompy Bits sitting in front of a mirror brushing his teeth. Maybe picking his teeth with the bones of his victims.
That's what I do. So, any questions so far? Anybody got anything? Kind of getting tired of hearing my own voice. Of course, I just turn around and realize Sammy's not at the computer. No, she is.
I need to go check on the dogs. Check on Uzi.
Now what I'd like is a bright green on there, and I'm just not going to get it by putting green down. So what I'm going to do It's coming in with just pure white. And fill in white everywhere where I'd like my green to be the brightest. Now I'll give this a few minutes to dry. And then I'll wash over it again with the green, and it'll pop. It'll stand out at that point. Questions on there?
I am.
Now, if you can't get the white as you'd like it, old Illustrator trick is to use gesso.
Bye, Rev. Bye, Devilique. Let's see here. Jesse says, is Tommy accepting commissions while working on these for Weird?
Counts on what it is. What is he thinking?
I don't know.
What are you thinking, brother? Okay, so we highlighted the tongue there. So we're gonna lay down green on top and watch out. Look how bright that green is now. This is the same exact green that I was just using that was barely making any tonality at all. Since I laid down the white, boom! It explodes to life. Did he have something?
He hasn't replied yet. once washed everything out, so I was readjusting it.
What are you at time-wise?
An hour and a half. Painting of Odin on $400 to $500 range.
The god Odin?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. We could take it. It just goes on the list. If he's cool with that.
So roughly, that would be what? What size? 18 by 24?
Yeah, something like that.
And right now, you only have a handful of commissions. So now would be the time to get it, to jump on it. If you can.
Yep. See, Jesse says, Norse god, yes, and not a warrior type, but a magician, traveler, seer type, preferably with his ravens. I can send payment tonight. Okay. Yeah, when I first lost my eyesight, I had 100 commissions left to do.
What did you say, honey?
I was telling him how when I first lost my eyesight, I had 100 commissions
yeah.
left to do. And I've gotten it down to less than 5, I believe.
Jesse's make 7. So what size is that going to be? 18 by 24?
Oh, sure. Yeah, 18 by 24. Oh, and I have to bang out a quick piece for the show. Right? Underwater scene.
The Levi, if you can, yes. He says it's okay if you can't. He understands.
Yeah.
But he said if you can. They can use it as an exclusive. If not, next year. If not, they'll have it for next year and they'll do t-shirts and stuff like that. It is official, Jesse. You are on the board. And I wrote legibly.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
How's he look?
Looks great. Real nasty.
He's got a red eye.
Ew.
What? What?
Sunday and Monday and Tuesday, it's going to drop into the 50s.
That's disgusting.
That's why I said ew. Winter is upon us. Yeah, Sunday, it's going to be 57. Monday, 59. Tuesday, 59. And then in the 80s to 60s the rest of the week. We're complaining about that. Meanwhile, the rest of the country's like 30 and 40s. Or just maybe 40s.
We normally don't participate in winter.
Yeah.
Tell me when we get to the 2-hour mark.
You're at an hour and 33 minutes. Jesse says, I think 57 was the high here today.
Ugh.
That's your fault for living there.
Where does he live?
Milwaukee? I think. Or near there. Minnesota. That was close.
Yeah, they're like right next to each other.
They're both cold, and no one really actually wants to live there. Doesn't Minnesota have that Mall of America?
It's closing.
Or, is it really?
Mm-hmm. It's going to close its doors.
That
Shut
sucks.
It down.
Why is that?
I don't know. I didn't read the article. I know that.
I've never been there. Not that it was a
It's like a mall. It's
but
just really big.
Yeah, it's like a city.
Actually, it's a little annoying because you can't really get around without getting lost.
Oh no, it's not closing. It's just closing on Thanksgiving.
They put an article out saying that it was just closing on Thanksgiving?
Yeah, USA Today. Mall of America makes bold move to close on Thanksgiving.
Hmm.
Well, because all the places are open, you know, because of Black Friday, they're opening Thursday night. They're closing, Thanksgiving night to sell more crap.
Yeah, which is stupid because everything that you could get at the store, you could get online the night before.
Yeah, Black Friday doesn't exactly have the same effect and allure that it once had. Oh, not here in Texas. It was around 77 degrees today. Oh, I'm sorry. They're the same color. Justin said that. Not here. In Texas, it was around 77 degrees today. I'm sorry, I misread that. Justin and Jesse have the same green, so I thought it was the same person. Because I didn't read the name. Lazy.
Spray the paint, please.
Sure.
That's us.
Trying to make it bad. What?
Come on, you see me do it 100 times.
I was doing it right. I didn't want to hit you or the painting. Jesse says, yeah, remember, this is the Midwest. Liquor stores are closed on Sunday and sidewalks roll up at 9 p.m.
That's right, they have blue laws.
And nothing good happens after midnight.
And why do you live there?
Because I think he's near his daughters.
Okay, well, that's legit.
I think he moved closer to his daughters.
I'd still be living in Jersey had I had a kid with my first wife.
You know, it's a good thing I'm using this... the laptop. I can see this in the first person, upside down-ish.
Yeah, having to paint it upside down kind of sucks. But I never think of it as a problem, only as an opportunity.
got two daughters and one son in the state. One son just joined the Air Force.
Oh, that's awesome. All I hear is you clicking away. With no music, I got nothing to concentrate on.
Okay.
So just tell me what you're doing so I don't.
Not doing anything.
What are you clicking on?
I'm adjusting the picture.
Well, then you're doing something.
Well, what? Do I have to tell you every second, every little fart that I'm doing stuff?
Yep.
Nope. Trying to fix the color on this. It's super purple. Super, super pinky purple. Like, there's no yellows in it at all. That's a little bit better. Well, that's really yellow. That one light, that cold light that you have to your left?
They're all the same light.
No, that one's yellow. The other one's...
If it's yellow, it should... This one?
That one is blue.
That's not a... Where do you see a cold light?
That's cold. Compared to this, it's cold. So it's making everything purple to the camera.
They're all sunlight bulbs. 5000K.
Okay, so the one in the lamp on the right is not correct, then. Because that's a yellow light.
Up there?
That is to your left. That one is a yellow light.
Shouldn't be.
It is. I'm looking at it. The color temperature difference.
Well, then it's got to get changed.
But the light that you have pointed directly on it is just making everything very cold. So I was just trying to compensate with the white balance, but it doesn't really know what to do.
I need to take a break. What?
Nothing.
You just made a
sound.
So what?
Jesse says... Oh, that's to me. Oh, okay. Jeremy says, just stop back in to take a look, and it looks amazing. Back to cleaning the garage. We're at an hour and 45. Jesse says, crap, I just organized my painting area and I knocked over my brush holder. It's like a game of pickup sticks. And to add to the fun, I have to use a jawed pickup reacher to gather them. Grr. That sucks. I'd say the same thing would happen to Tommy, but I would just end up picking everything up instead. Right?
Yep.
So you know what the moral of that story is, right? What's the moral of the story, Tommy?
Always marry a Sam. I wish my dad was still alive to see this.
Yeah?
Yeah, he would have enjoyed this a lot. He would have loved
being able to watch it on the computer?
He would have been able to be able to watch. You know? He was always amazed at how I do this. And he was pretty much my only supporter. But my father believed that I was tough as nails and could take anything.
You've proved him right so far.
All I see it as is I do what I have to.
Your dad call you a grunt?
Yeah, he called me a grunt because a grunt can take anything.
They keep coming, right?
No matter what happens, they'll just keep coming. Knock them down 100 times, they'll get back up 101. I just wanted to make him proud.
Well, I think you did. can stop whenever you're ready.
Yeah, we're gonna stop right after I'm done with this. So I lay this down. I'll probably stop, have something to eat, relax a little bit.
And then come back and continue painting?
And then come back and continue painting, that's right.
Gotta make up for lost time?
Yeah, gotta make up for the year. Year in the dark, it's gotta be counted for. To have this painting done by Monday.
Right. So we can move on to the next one?
Yes.
I think Nathan thought it was going to take a lot longer.
Why do you say that?
Oh. Why do I say that?
Yeah.
Well, just because, you know, such a big piece, and
it's not exactly going slow.
No.
Nor is it exactly going fast. It's going the exact speed it should. Tomorrow we gotta go get the varnish. I always like the sound of that.
Sound of what?
The paint.
The brush on the...
The brush scraping on the paper.
Mm.
Sometimes it makes that...
Scrapey sound?
Scrapey sound. Normally it's silent, but...
Depends on the bristles and the paper and the paint.
Yeah. Okay. Let's wrap it up.
Okie dokies. So we're gonna cut it here, folks. Whoever's remaining. be back on Monday, 7 p.m., taking the weekend off of streaming anyway, mostly because I got lots of work to do as well. And tomorrow we should have some eBay stuff up on the store, some originals, past, present, future. Any words of wisdom, my awesome husband? Don't eat yellow snow.
Be brave. Take chances. Nothing ventured, nothing gained. Come Monday, it is most likely to be finished. And I'll be showing that off and knee deep in the next illustration. It never ends. Thank God.
Yeah, if Tommy's done, you got Justin's remarks to do. Mm-hmm. All a bajillion of them that he purchased.
Okay.
So maybe we can do that on Monday if you're done with this.
Yeah.
How's that sound, Justin? He's like, yeah. We did not forget, I promise. Jeremy's like, and mine, me. All right, guys, I am going to cut it here. Everyone have a wonderful, safe weekend. Tommy, say goodnight.
Good night.
Maybe sound it a little bit nicer and happier that you're painting.
Sorry, was that not happy enough for you?
No, you sounded bored. You're like, nah. Kind of just bleh, oozed out of your mouth.
Good night.
There's Oliver. Okay. Say goodnight, Tommy. All right. Goodnight, everyone. We will see you on Monday.